I'm Sebastian St. James. Exactly how do I make money with dividends? Exactly. I need to know. On a previous video, Anthony asks, hi, just a question. If you say buy a share at $100 with 10% yield, so 10 bucks, does it lock that price in at the time of purchase? Say if that stock was sitting at $200 on the date that they pay the dividend, would you get $20 or the 10% at the time you bought? Kind of important for me because of, say, JB Hi-Fi's price at the moment. Anthony. So, Anthony, let's answer your question for you. This question is all about dividend yield. If a company pays you $10 in dividends, is that good? Yes, all money is good. If a company gives you $10, $20, $5, that is wonderful. Thank you very much, company. Specifically, it just depends. If I buy a share for $10 and the company pays me $10 in dividends, that's 100% return. Yippee! That is wonderful. However, if I paid $10,000 for that share and they paid me $10, that's 0.1% dividend. Boo! No! We don't want that. Well, we do. We're not going to say no, but that's not a particularly good return at all. Anthony says, if you say buy a share at $100 with 10% yield, so 10 bucks. So let's do the math. $10 in dividends divided by $100, which is the price that you paid for the share, times by 100, because we change it to percentage, equals 10% dividend yield. He is correct. Does it lock in that price at the time of purchase? Say if the stock was sitting at $200 on the date that they paid the dividend, would you get $20 or 10% at the time you bought? Anthony's asking, is dividend yield set like an interest rate at a bank? So if I have $1,000, I put it in a term deposit at a bank. And I know my interest rate is, say, 5%. I'm going to get 5% back per annum. If I put it in for 6 months, then I'm obviously going to get 2.5%. Is that how dividend yields work? No, they're not totally related to that at all. Dividend yields do not work like interest rates. They're not predictable in the same way. Dividend yields do not speak about the future at all. They are not a promise of things to come. So this is how it works. Dividends are typically paid multiple times a year. If you're in the US, they are paid typically 4 times a year quarterly. In Australia, they are biannual or twice a year every 6 months. Imagine that company ABC in January pays $5 dividend. In July, 6 months later, they pay $5. So in the last 12 months, that is $10 dividend in total. Hang on, it depends on what time of year I'm talking about. Is that calendar year, which ends in December? Is it financial year, which ends on the 30th of June? Or what happens if I'm talking about August or September or another month? How do I work out dividends then? So if company ABC in July 2021 is paying $5, in January 2022 they are paying $5, how does that work out? Dividend yield always works on the most recent payment, so the last 12 months. And whatever dividends have been paid within that particular period, doesn't matter what they are, then that is the dividends that we're talking about. So how long is this dividend figure relevant for? Well, it's relevant until the next dividend is paid. So if you're paid a dividend today, then that dividend amount that we use to calculate the dividend yield is fixed for, say, another 6 months. Then the new dividend comes and we update that figure. We take off the previous one from 2 payments ago, keep the one from last payment, use the current one, and that's how we update it. So every 6 months in Australia, the dividend amount will change. If company ABC in July 2021 pays $5, in January 2022 it paid $5, we are here in time. Estimated in July 2022, they're going to pay $6. How much is the dividend of the dividend yield calculation? Well, the dividend for the dividend yield calculation is $10. We look at the last 12 months, 5 plus 5 equals 10, 6 in the future, good. When I get to the future, I'll calculate it in. For now, I'm only interested in the last 12 months. So dividend yield uses the last 12 months, except when it doesn't. I will explain that shortly. Does dividend yield include special dividends? And what's a special dividend anyway? A special dividend is a dividend which comes from a rich, progressive family. Tarquin, you know that Mummy and Daddy think you're very special. We have placed you on the waiting list for the Steiner School for Gifted Children, and I'm sure you'll get in. No, not that kind of special. A special dividend is simply a dividend that is paid in addition to regular dividends. Why might they be paying dividends out of regular dividends? The answer is because of a financial windfall. A typical example is if there is a sale. Let's say that the company ABC has a subsidiary of XYZ that they sell off, and then suddenly they've got all this cash. What are they going to do with it? They may choose to pay that out in a dividend, but it's a huge amount, and it's come, say, in March, and dividends are not till, say, July, so they may pay it out as a special dividend, a dividend that is not only separate in time, but it's in addition to any other dividend. So if you're expecting two, you'll now get three. Company ABC in July pays $5. In March, they pay a $1 special dividend. In January, they pay a $5 special dividend. The total dividend, therefore, is $5 plus $1 plus $5 equals $11. And of course, the future dividend is irrelevant here. I have another video coming out which talks about a totally different feature about dividends, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out. That is the dividend part. We're now totally clear, but what is the yield? Yield is the amount of return. If you're a farmer, that could be something like 12 bushels of wheat per acre. But what's a bushel? A bushel in Britain is 8 gallons, which is 36.4 litres. In the US, it is 64 pints, which is 35.2 litres. So a bushel is a unit of volume. A bushel may be a volume measurement, but in the case of wheat, a bushel is 60 pounds. Oats weighs 40 pounds and corn weighs 50 pounds. Good, so we understand what yield means to a farmer. What does it mean in the case of shares? Dividend yield is the amount of dividends paid over the last 12 months per acre. Okay, so it's not per acre, it's divided by the current share price. If the dividend is $10, the current share price is $100. The yield is 0.1, but we want percentage yield, therefore it is 10%. Is that dividend yield calculated on the day I purchased the price? The answer is yes. Until tomorrow, where the share price changes and therefore the dividend yield changes. So the dividend yield, the share price component of that, changes on a day-by-day basis. It is not fixed at any point in time. If the dividends are $10, the share price yesterday was $100, therefore the dividend yield is 10%. But if today's share price goes up to $110, the dividend yield right now is 9.09%. So the dividend yield fluctuates on a daily basis because the share price fluctuates on a daily basis. In addition to the share price fluctuating, the dividend yield also fluctuates on a biannual basis because the dividend itself changes on a biannual basis, or four times if you're in the US. The dividend so far paid out is $10. The share price yesterday is $100, a dividend of 10%. However, the dividends now have gone up to $11. The share price today is still $100, therefore the dividend yield is 11%. So either the share price changing or the dividend amount changing, if they paid out new dividends, will change the dividend yield. Anthony asks, just to confirm, is a dividend payout based on the current share price at the time of dividend payment, not at the time you happen to purchase the shares? Thank you for your awesome video. And thank you, Anthony. Dividends are actually not based on dividend yields. What are you talking about? This whole video is based on dividend yield. Sure, to you it is, but to the company it isn't. Dividends are actually based on cents per share. I shall explain exactly how it works from the company's point of view. Company ABC has $10 million excess in cash that it needs to get rid of course, in dividends. The company happens to have 5 million shares. $10 million divided by 5 million in shares equals $2 per share. $2 per share, what is a dividend yield? It doesn't matter, the company doesn't care. They've got a certain amount of cash divided by the number of shares which they've got. That's all that really matters to them. So from the company's point of view, dividend yield doesn't mean anything. Company ABC, its dividend is $2 per share. The share price today is $10, therefore the dividend yield is 20%. Or alternately, let's say the share price today is $15, but the dividend is still the same, $2 has been paid out. Therefore, the dividend yield is 13.33%. So dividend yield is something that we think about afterwards, and the company itself does not work in dividend yield, just cents per share. This is all true, except when it isn't. Some share brokers actually calculate dividend yield totally differently. I shall explain, but everything that you've learned up till now, that dividends is based on the last 12 months of dividend, is true. That's the formal definition. What I'm going to explain to you now is the slightly wacky way, but I'll explain why, that some brokerages calculate dividend yield. The average of the actual dividends over the last 12 months and the consensus projected dividend for the next 12 months, all divided by the current price. The dividend yield calculation excludes special dividends. If no consensus forecasts are available, then the dividend yield is calculated using the total dividend for the last financial year. Please note that this figure is not adjusted for special dividends, asset sales, asset acquisitions, and organic earnings growth of the company. Oh, what does all that mean? In the last 12 months, the actual dividend paid is $10. The projected dividend is $12. Therefore, they average out the two. 10 plus 12 divided by 2 equals $11. Interesting. So this is different, isn't it? What are they trying to do here? The brokerage is trying to give you some sort of sense about the future. In reality, dividend yield is based on the past, but if they've got an inkling about what the projected future dividend is, then they're giving you a bit of a heads up on that by including that in their calculation. No, this is not the formal definition of dividend yield, but it can be helpful. Also keep in mind that they are excluding the special dividend. Why? Well, if there's a special dividend paid this year, the chance is that it will not be paid next year. So if you're trying to get some sort of understanding of what the dividend is likely to be, which is the whole purpose of this wacky combination, then you want to exclude special dividends. In reality, special dividends are used to calculate dividend yield, but not how my broker calculates it. If I look at a dividend yield amount on a website, how do I know if it's historic, so the formal definition, or whether it's projective, like some brokers do? The answer is you don't. You have no idea. So assume it's the formal definition. Assume it's historically based, unless you can find evidence to the contrary. But there we go, introducing a level of confusion. Thank you, brokers, for that. Now we've answered Anthony's question. You need to go and watch the video that caused Anthony to ask this question in the first place. Go ahead and click on it here.